Thank you, Pastor Jen. Thank you so much for your kind invitation, and it's great to be here. You go on that side. I like this side. I have my favourite side. I'm going to wake up. Okay. So the very first time I ever preached at a Burmese church was in Sunshine with Pastor David Mungpi.
Ina apat masa pen mata Burmese church jang kolgam ma kolgam ya polpite to kisai pen sia David Mung ma Sunshine a om teyang mata tatanga preach masa penning.
And that day was Pastor Appreciation Day.
Toki tak jang a pastor te pak toy na ni chi om sang ma tuang pai.
And I had never heard of that before.
Toa pastor pak toy na chi pen ken zang ei lo hing.
Because we don't have it here in Australia.
Australia gama ko tua ran nei ngei lo chi khale khat ke pa toy na mo.
But after we had that service, I said to Pastor David.
Aya nga tua service sunga tua pa toy na nei hi tak changa sia David mung kha gaining.
Can you make sure that you always invite me on Pastor Appreciation Sunday?
Ina tua mate tua Pastor Appreciation ni dena mate keinong sam sak thei diam che na mo ge ni che.
There you go. Thank you. It's a dad joke.
Tata pen bel gen te namate hata no khat amai again hina mo.
I want to speak to you today about faith.
Tu ni pen upna thung gen nuaming.
I want to speak to you particularly about faith, have faith in God.
Ina bang hiam chile kong gen upna a athuk zo amate pasien sunga umnya tun upna ne nya tun.
The Apostle Paul in the book of Romans chapter 12 says that everyone has been given a measure of faith.
Rom alian som leni sung anel thumna bangyan che le pasiani no te tunga mate ong pyak za to ki zuin ki ngai sut be zon la akilom chang khat bekin ki ngai sunun chi.
No one can say that they have no faith.
Toi changa mi khat be pyoin mate ken upna ne keng chi the om lo hi.
Because the Bible says that God has given us each a measure of faith.
Bahang chile pasian kamalin mate ivek piwa khatsiat tunga upna mate ong pya hi chi again hi.
But in the Gospel of Mark chapter 11 we find Jesus speaking these words that tell us about a different kind of faith.
Ina mark som le khatna som ni le thum som ni le li ki kal sunga pasianin mate hi upna pen khat le khajong akibang lowa pya hi chi na gel hi.
Jesus speaks to his disciples about mountain moving faith.
Jesus in ben mate ama I nung zui te khyanga mual te akiling sak zo upna chi pen na gen hi.
I don't know about you, but the words that Jesus spoke on this day are quite extraordinary in their impact.
Ina bangyam sile no bangda nangai suthiam mel ken thekeng mate a hi hanga ama ading pen Jesus a ading pen mate again na pen bang chiring ya khoi zodio tole nam dang phadeu mate.
So let's read together from the Gospel of Mark chapter 11 verse 23 and 24.
Toi chatunya mark mate maka mo maka mo som lakhat alian som lakhat aneu som ni le thum pan som ne li na sim khom leng.
You
want me
it.
To? Yep. Okay. Can sim ninga? Jesu ina mau te kyanga upna nei un. Upna na nei na kule himol kyanga na omna panin pai khia in tuipi sung kiden na in chileu chin nalung sim sung ua upla na omlo in na gen bangun piang tak tak ding hi chi in na upna kule na chi bangun hong piang ding hi toa hi manin no te kyanga kong gen ina na khat pyo pyo nangeru chang in nga ding chi in umun toa hi le nanget pyo pyo u nanga dingu hi.
Amen. So today I want to talk to you about how to turn your measure of faith into mountain moving faith.
Toi changa tunin mate kong gen op na bangyam chile aki chap te thei up na ma aki te thei up na pen aki te up na no pen mate hi mwal pi te aling sak mate a he sak up na pana koida na piang thei ding chi to gen ning yang.
In James 2:26 he says this: for as the body without spirit is dead, so faith without works is dead also.
In James chapter mate ni na alian ni aneu som ni lagu na bang chiam chile pum pi pe mate kha lo wa si ma bang in chi up na lo wa mate na jong pen a si to ki bang hi chi na piang thai lo ma up na lo wa.
So James tells us that the way to turn our measure of faith into mountain moving faith is to do something with it.
toy changa hi James sunga bangen upna hiam chile a bangaya hi upna lowa mate na khat pepo piang thading chi pen a piang thailo thu hi na khat pepo piang na upna ine ngiat kul hi.
For me, the mountain in the verse represents the problems or the obstacles, the difficulties that we face in moving forward in our life.
This one? Oh, sorry, can you repeat that again, please?
The mountain in the verse represents the difficulties and the challenges that we face to move forward in life.
Oh, ina hi vasunga atinop na ben bangaya hi mualpi tele mate. He mualpi tele challenges chichanga singkho mu tuam tuam te ben mate bang chiring hiam chile akikhin theinang mo akikhin theinang twa dinga bangaya
when we get to the
akikhin theina ding hi chi twa dingang sin sakna.
Don't stop for too long or I'll jump in.
Sorry.
When we get to the end of the service today, I want to pray for you, and we're going to believe that God will move mountains in your world.
He service man tak changa no waring thunget sakcha noming je no in namwal pi te ku mate na khin zo na ding thunget sak noming.
Amen. So get ready, because when we get to the end, I need you to help me.
Toi changa na ready kholun mate hi aman tak changa pen ngu na ding nong hu thei na ding wa mate twa dinga ke saming.
What is it that's stopping you from going to the next level in God?
Toi changa na level mate pasian kha na kinai sok sem sem nang nang next level pen bangin ong bang chiringa ong khol sakhyam.
What mountain needs to get moved out of the way so you can go forward?
Tang tang na pai thei nang a mate bang mol pi te in mate ong bang chiringa ong khak tan hiam.
The first thing that I see that we need to change our faith from a measure to a mountain moving is a conviction in our heart that believes in God.
In a bangiam chile tua I akite mate akichang tan tua upna pen mate ma bang chidinga tua mual pi pen akikhin theinang pen mate eile eki mo sakna mate ilakhet kul eile eki mo sakna pen iet phot kul masa saing.
If something is a conviction, it doesn't change with the circumstances or with how you're feeling.
Toi changa khat pyo pyo nang le nang mate na ki hen chim nang le nang na ki mo sakna khat pyo pyo om le pen bang bang ong piang ai jong pen ki khi chip mate ki swak ta lo ding hi.
A conviction is a deeply held belief that doesn't change.
Conviction chi tak changa pen bangaya a ki hen kya mo sakna tuam tuam mo sakna tuam tuam ei le ei ki mo sak.
All of us faced in the last 2 years a time when we weren't allowed to come to church.
Bang tang yam hi le no abaisan rungkuma jong mate ei pen apulama puswak khunom lo mate ki khum chip chi om he.
And we were supposed to stay home and watch it on the TV.
Ivek piwa pen ina kyom chip ina TV anina bang tang piang yam apulama chi bek mate to bek ki mu hi.
And as much as I'm glad that we have the technology to do that, it wasn't what I wanted to do.
Bangza taka technology mate set van tom tom om hang om sang hang mate ken pen tua ben nuam sak keng nom sat tuan keng.
I believe the church is the gathering together of God's people to worship him.
Bang chile ke I up na pen mate ivek piwa ki kai khom le yai ding ina por pi khan mate ki mu khom ngai ngai ding pasian pe khom ning tua pen ke I u na hi.
I hold a conviction deep in my heart about going to church every week.
Toi changa keile kei mate I keile kei ki hen chip mate keile kei ka ki hen chip na be bangaya byakina pai thailo chi khat ma.
And it's the same with faith. We need to actually hold a conviction that our God is a God that has given us faith and that we can change things by using that faith.
Toi changa eile ei zong mate hoi taka ki gending athaka mate ki phok sak ding ina pen pasian pen mate ei pasian to khitak changa ei haksan na le imwal te pen akhin sak jo pasian chi pen ei le ei ki phok sak den ding thu pi.
Throughout COVID, a lot of people stopped helping in church. They fell away in their commitment to the house of God.
Ina COVID sung tanga mate ina pasian abeding mate mi tampi takin pen bezo lo ma ina om chi pai changa pai ding jong tha da ta mate ki pe khe zo non tak tak lo hi.
It's not enough that you have a commitment, you need to have a conviction.
Ina tu le tua mate tun ki mu thei mana tua rana hilo dingena tua ran bang bangong piangai jong mate ei lampana mate I bang chiringa ele e iki bang khat nang mo bangaya e betan tanding china mo thanem lo wa betan tanding.
Stop doing that.
Sorry. It just comes out in my mind.
The second thing that I see is that we have to get a hold of our thought life.
Ina ani ina bang yam chile e e ngai sut na te ma te thupi sak ding tua pen ngai sut kului ngai sut khwa hi.
The Bible says that we're to bring every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ.
La sang thoi nong gen tak chang a ma te a vek pia bang yam
captivity, where is it? The Bible said, sorry,
bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ, from 1 Corinthians.
Oh, Corinthian masa na mo bang si hiam chile. Okay, I don't have it. La siang tho sunga mate avek pia bangaya pasian I makaina mate. Okay, I'm just still searching it.
You're good, just say what I say.
All right. Okay,
because sometimes I'll refer to scriptures, I won't actually go there.
Okay,
in the book of which one? Galatians. Yeah. It says, whatever things are good, whatever things are perfect, whatever things of a good report, think about those things.
In a lai sang so sunga chi hi mate bang bang ai zong a hoi na khem pyo pen mate to te hoi a chi khem pyo hoi na khem pyo pen ngai sunun chen.
The trouble we have as human beings is sometimes our thoughts can go into the wrong direction.
Khat ve ve changa e hak san na te ngai su tak changa pen ilung sim pen a ko ya pai khe thei mate.
But the Bible says, as a follower of Jesus, we have to discipline our thoughts and bring them under control.
And
I found this verse in Romans chapter 4 that I just love so much.
It says
concerning Abraham, not being weak in faith, he did not consider his own body already dead since he was about 100 years old.
Ina hi sunga lai sang tho ong sim leng mate lai sang tho ong sim leng lai sang tho sunga na swan le khak te aksi za in tam ding ngi chin ki gel ma bangin tua banga pian theina ding lamen na a om nai lo pi ma in Abrahamin a om lamen a hi manin minam tam pi te pu pi a swak sak hi.
So he wasn't weak in faith, he was strong in faith, and what it meant was he didn't think about the circumstances of his own body.
Ina ama chim nam na bang hiam chile ama pen hi up na pen a tha nem hi lo up na khau ma ma a hianga ama I din mun pen hi mi tam pi taki pu pi piang ling chi pen to pen ngai suni.
His focus was on the promise of God, which said, you're going to be the father of many nations.
Sometimes when
we're faced with a challenge or a problem that becomes a mountain that stands before us, all we do is think about the problem.
Khat ve ve changa en mate seng khom mu ai jong mate in a takhi tak changa hak san na mual pi ai jong mate tam pi tak om tak changa en ben tua ham san na mate to pe ta na be bek en hi hang.
And as a result we get worried, we get concerned, we can be afraid, we can be anxious, all sorts of things because we're focusing on the wrong thing.
In a en bang chi yam chile tua teng pen inga isu su tak changa ei lama bang piang lung hi mo na mate thanem na lao na ling na lung bangaya tuam tuam mate tua teng bek bek kine hi che bahang yam chile tuai petana be bek en mit chuan masai changa hi.
Come on, we have to do what Abraham did, give no thought to the problem but think about the promise of God for your future.
In a bang chi yam chile Abraham nun tang na elleng mate to cha Abraham nun tang na sunga to hak sat na te kho apyang thailo na te khong en masalo ding ina pasian in bang hi thai ding bang sem thai ding chi pen mate en nun chi akam cham ma.
God's will is that you overcome your problems.
Pasian ni deina pen na nang I petana khem pe na gwal zo ding pen amai deina hi.
But if I keep thinking negative thoughts and focus on the problem, I can never move that problem with my faith.
A hiang a pen hi negative chi changa pen apyang thailo ding chi dan khong a ilung hi mo na ma te ilung hiang na khom le pen to pen bang mang pyang thailo ding hi.
The third thing that I see that will help us to move from a measure of faith to mountain moving faith is our words.
Ina atum na bangyam chile atum na hi chana ki chang tan mate upna ne ki ke upna upna pai mol pi cha cha upna mate akiling zo na nga bangyam chile compound na mate compound na hi.
James says in chapter 3 and verse 10, out of the same mouth proceed blessing and cursing. My brethren, these things ought not to be so.
James thumna soma bangchiham chile kamkhat sungpanin thupale thusia puswak khom hi sangkam teo hi bang ahiding hi hetlo hi chi.
What we say when faced with a mountain of opposition and a problem is going to have a lot to do with what outcome we receive.
Tai changa hi chibangin mate mual pizza in alian mate petna inei tak changin pen tua lai taka I kampau pen mate I kampau khadin pen tua I imailam hunding pen mate onggel sakhi ongpiang sakhi.
I noticed something about the life and ministry of Jesus that I didn't see anywhere else in the Bible.
Ina lai siang tho sunga mate ken kamuna jaisuin hi leitunga ngwak lai mate ngom lai taka ana sepna pen mundang khatpe ba kibang lo hi om ngei lo hi to dan.
During his ministry, Jesus would oftentimes stop in the middle of a circumstance or situation and tell people where their faith was at.
Ina bangyam chile tua tanga enlang mate khatpe pyo aman ama I na sepna mate kem pyo wa mate tun hi upna to kisai thu khatpe pyo mate gen dinga kisabale tua khol nya dina upna vai thu pen mate gen nya thi.
When there was a storm on the Sea of Galilee and the disciples thought they were going to drown and they woke Jesus up, he calmed the storm, then he turned to them and said, how is it that you have no faith?
Ina bang chiam chile to anung zui te nun dang na bang enleng mate ina hi hui pi tui wal pi teng pai lai taka bang chia jaisu I mo hya amao lao ling ke changa upna nei lo upna kiam tak changa jaisu pe ra phota cha jaisu in to hui pi tui wal pi te dai sak phot mo to khit tak changa to thu gen hi mate dong gen na upna ko ya om hiam.
When he told the disciples when there was a vast crowd, you give them something to eat. And they went, but master, we only have these few loaves and fish.
Ina bang siam chile mi tam pi tak tua anwak na ding muna mate and awak na ding muna bang hiam chile hi mi pi te mate hi kami pi te an pia ina chi tak changa disciple ten mate nong zui ten ko khanga mo pao mo tom le mate nga tom bek om hi lo mo chi.
And Jesus said to them, O ye of little faith.
Jesus to again leo leo hi mate upna neo nei mi te o chi.
And I started to realize how did Jesus know where people's faith level was at.
Ina toi changa ken to ben thei sem sem ing mate Jesus in twa na ho pi tak changa mi hing te I o upna level pen koi tan tan koi cha cha om hiam che.
The only thing that he had to go on was what they were saying.
Ina jaisu in pen mate amawi kampana bangtangeniam chi pana mate thehi.
And we don't see it anywhere else in the Bible, just in the ministry of Jesus, that he took the time to tell people what kind of faith their words were projecting.
Ina bangyam chile adang mun khan pepewa omlo mate mulo hiang ina ahyang a jaisu I ama I anasep na muna mate leitungom lai taka anasep na muna I tua upna to ki sai pen mate tua tanga imailam ding pen bangteng gen khol hiam yupna pana chia tungtona en hi.
Remember the time when the Roman centurion asked Jesus, would you come and heal my servant?
Tua Roman ga ka pa mo tua in jaisu khyanga ke katapa mate nong dam sak zodiam chi hi.
Then he said, Jesus, you don't really need to come, just speak the word and my servant will be well.
Ina tua pan long bang chi hiam chi le pen nang nong pai kul ke mate ahyang an nang kampana mong gelel damin dam ta he na chi na ga le ka kai kana sem pan mate tua na geni na dam lel ding hi chia um hi.
The scripture says Jesus turned to his disciples and said, I tell you the truth, I haven't seen faith like this, no, not in all of Israel.
Ina jaisun bang chiam chile anung zui te hianga ngai na mate ama awla ma ngai na enin chi ichik ma hunin mate hita pa za a upna nei mate om loading hi chi again hi mungai nai king chi.
What was the difference was what they said when confronted with the problem or the mountain of opposition.
Toi changa hi mwalpi banga mate alian azai petna omma ta sele mate ei kampau penin mate na khempiu khel the chi na penong thei sak nom hing.
What are we saying about the mountain that is stopping us going forward in the things of God?
You know,
maybe we're sick. Maybe we need a job. Maybe we need lots of things. What are we saying about the problems that we need to move out the way? All right, so here we go. We need a conviction. We need to control our thought life, and we need to make sure we speak faith when we're confronted with mountains of opposition. The fourth thing that we need is not just to speak the right things, but to have some confidence in what we're saying. You can say things in a certain way, but it doesn't convince anybody that you really believe it. We need to become those people who, out of our conviction, our thoughts, and our words of faith, we are confident in our expectation of what God is going to do. Amen. Here's your memory verse, all right? 1 John 5:14. Says, now this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. And if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have been granted the petitions that we have asked of him.
Ina ate na ma de na to kituakin inget nak le inget kem pe pasianin hong peding hi chi in kimwana lung sim inei hi chi.
This is what it says. It says, this is our confidence that if we ask, God hears and says yes.
Ina toi changa ei mate lungmon khamwan na bangyam chile en ama khyanga inget nakale pasianina zama zayina to kitakcha inget ma banga man peding hi.
We are not to go before God in hope, but in confidence. And whatever it is that you need from the Lord today, have confidence that he says, yes, I'm going to meet you, and we're going to move that mountain out of the way. When we speak in faith and confidence, something happens that turns our words into a prophetic declaration over the future.
I
want my words to be a prophetic declaration over the lives that I have the opportunity to speak over. He says, this is the confidence we have that if we ask according to his will, it is not God's will that you are stopped in your progress by a mountain of opposition.
Amen.
That's good. I like to hear a bit coming back at me. We're at the last one. This is the last one. Getting ready to pray, all right? The last thing. The last thing is called spiritual authority. I believe that this is a great issue in the church of today. We need to understand if we are Christians, if we're God's people, that God has given us spiritual authority to move mountains. How are we going to reach a world that's lost and dying unless we, the church, can stand up with spiritual authority to overcome even the challenges that face us?
In Matthew 28,
we find the Great Commission.
Matthew somni legyan na a bang chi hiam chile.
Matthew 28. And this is what Jesus says in the Great Commission. All authority has been given to me in heaven, in earth, and under the earth. Jesus told his disciples then, and then all of us that would follow, that all authority had been given to him when he raised victorious from the grave.
There's
no authority in the heavens, on the earth, or in hell that has not been given to Jesus Christ.
And
after he said that, he said, therefore, I'm sending you. He sent us out with an impartation of his authority over everything that would stand in the way of God's kingdom. In the Gospel of Luke, chapter 10 and 19, Jesus says this. Behold, I give you authority over all of the works of the enemy, to trample on snakes and scorpions, and nothing will by any means harm you. How many people understood it the first time? Go on.
Okay. Gulpi le mate. Momaite nasi gom na ding u le nagalte u nazo na ding u no te tunga wang le na kahong pezoa amaute in no te bangma hong chi zo lo ding u hi.
Jesus gave his authority to his followers over all the works of the enemy.
In a Jesus pe anung zui te khyang mate agalte atot chil na nga.
I need you to get this. There are two words in the New Testament that are translated as power.
In New Testament Old Testament,
they are Greek words, and the first one is dunamis.
Greek light, okay, and Judaism, see,
and what it means is like energy, explosive power, the workings of power.
In a adik pe pen bang yam sila pen tua pen avang lian mama mate power anay mama hat mama mate tua china hi.
The second word that's used is called exousia.
Ani ina pen exousia kiti hi.
And exousia means authority. When Jesus calmed the storm, he didn't release energy to stop it. He spoke a word. Jesus operated through his whole earthly ministry with spiritual authority. So we understand when we get filled with the Holy Spirit, that's the dunamis.
But here
we understand that Jesus also gave us spiritual authority to use. We are not to accept the way things are. We are to be the agents of the Lord Jesus Christ in bringing change to our world and to everybody else's world. So I hope that you've been thinking about what it is you need to move in your world, because now we're going to pray and believe together to release spiritual authority to move mountains in Jesus' name. This is what I need you to do. I'm going to pray, right? But what I need you to do is not stay there silent. I want you to begin to speak to the mountain that's in your way. If you're afflicted with some sickness or pain, I want you to tell it to move out of your world. When you became a Christian, you moved out of the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light. You are not the possession of sickness or disease. You belong to the Lord Jesus Christ. So sickness and pain and all those things, they're trespassing on private property. So when I pray, I want you to evict them. Tell them you're not welcome here. This property doesn't belong to you.
You've
got to pack your bags and move out. And I don't care what it is you face. You know, if you need a job, or if you need a breakthrough, if you feel like you're under some sort of depression or anxiety or whatever it is, you need to tell it to move out of your world, because you're not going to put up with it being there. So right now, as I begin to pray, I want you to start to declare over your own life that you're free of these things, and tell them, move out. I'm not welcoming you here anymore. I don't care what the doctor said or what his prognosis was. I'm not believing that. I belong to Jesus. I am not going to entertain or host these things in my world anymore.
kilung gim sak no lo ding hing chia ki gen ning yang tang ko ke ding yang.
All right, so you can stop now. I'm going to pray, right? And even if you don't understand me, I'm declaring spiritual authority to be released over your lives.
Toi cha ke thu ngen ding mo ken kam pen no lo ding aman pen ang declaring ma te no lam pa na pen up na to de na teng ke pyong chi ma bang again ke zia zia ding mo lon ke ding.
And as I pray, I want you to begin to pray, and I want you to begin to cast out those things, to speak to them and tell them, get out of my life. Mountain, move out of the way.
In at ken thu ko nget ki kala mate to teng khem pe una nun tang na suan na dei lo khem pe mate a hoi lo na teng khem pe hol khe nya ding mate tang ko nya ding na puswak sak nya ding hi mwal pi te ling lon khe mang ding hiang.
Amen. So Father, we thank you today for the revelation of spiritual authority. And right now amongst this congregation with these people, we would declare over every one of their lives that mountains are moving in Jesus' name. Sickness, break your hold, loose your hold on them and let them go. You're being evicted today. Opposition that would prevent them from moving forward into what you have for them, Father. Whatever it is, Lord, we declare in spiritual authority that its power is broken today in Jesus' name. Father God, let doors and opportunities open up for your people as they take a hold of this revelation in faith and begin to declare over their lives, over their families, over their homes, over their businesses, over their employment, over their health. Father, we declare mountains of opposition move out the way because God's people are moving forward in faith that moves mountains. Thank you, Lord. Right now, Father, we release it on every life, on every home, on every address, on every circumstance, on every illness, on every condition, over every problem that stands in the way. Father God, as we declare in faith and release by the sword of the Spirit your promise over our lives, we believe that you're moving in spiritual authority to declare a new day of release over God's people. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Right now, Holy Spirit, we give way to you to move in the circumstances of your people. Thank you, Lord, for doors opening. Thank you, Lord, for those that are wandered from the faith coming home. Thank you, Lord, for those who need employment. Jobs are opening up for them. Thank you, Lord, for those with sickness today. It's packing its bags and it's moving out. Friends, you need to consider yourself as someone with a sticker on you says, no trespassing. No trespassing, right? You've got to issue the eviction notice of spiritual authority to everything that tries to come against your life. Father, I pray for addictions to be broken in Jesus' name. I pray for dependencies to be broken. Amen. They're packing their bags, they're moving out. They're setting God's people free. Amen. Father, because we want to become an army that knows how to use Amen. Spiritual authority to win the world for Amen. Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Right now, Father. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, Father. Amen. Now, you know what you need to do, right? This is good on Sunday, but let Monday be a day you still continue to speak faith into every opposition. Don't ring up someone to talk about your problem. Ring up heaven and declare and speak it out in the Spirit. You're moving out of my world. The children that are misbehaving, you just declare over them. You're going to be wonderful, raised in God's house. You're going to be a champion for Jesus. You're going to do great things for the kingdom of God. Don't worry about their problems. Start to speak life. Speak courage. Speak faith in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you. So good to be here. Great job, Mary. Well done.
Then amate again now song again na tuni pen Sunday ai hanga mate Monday ni tak changa jong tua upna kampau pen mate gen learning itu ita te khanga jom mate nang pen thupanga mi hi te nang ban pasien zat mi nya thi te mate thupanga mi nya thi te chia I kampana upna to I pulak nya ding hi che na mate siapa tung panang yen na hi